guys, my name is Sadiq Abdi from Abdi Travels. Hope you are there's a huge wind gust, so I believe that my voice would not be clear, so I'm quite short with the gimbal here. So just wanted to tell the psychology of an animal, right? So ever if you actually cross paths with an wild animal, you have to always remember one thing. Keep one thing in mind, that always walk from the back rather than walking from the front. Because as I have shown you the videos ahead, right, no matter if it's a snake, it's a four-limbed animal, it's a tiger, whatsoever, if you cross from the front, there's a huge amount of chance that you would be attacked, or you would be actually, they would defend themselves from you would think that it's an attack, right? So just be careful with this. There's a technique for it. Always go from the behind if you have to. Otherwise, just stay calm, stay as it is. If it's a tiger, don't show your back, don't run. If you run, you are dead. You might be aware with Sundarban Delta, the Sundarban tigers are quite adaptive to like eating humans, because they are mostly man eaters. So in Sundarban Delta, most of the fishermen who are actually boat owners, they wear a mask which is on the back of the head. Subsequently, the tiger sees that head and it attacks from the front, which means that it attacks the fisherman from the front, which is the eyes. Human, we can see like more mostly like a 130 degree angle view, so they can actually defend themselves. Any particular fisherman would be able to defend themselves once there is an attack from the front, most likely. So this is a technique that they follow in boats, and this is a right hand thumb rule which you can say, that ever if you actually encounter any animal in the wild, always try to make escape path from the back rather than from the front. If it's from the front, you are dead, kapoof, it's over, right? So this is just a small tech which is helpful for people who want to go on wild, and mostly they are solo travelers, or if they are in a short group, small group, and it would be difficult if you actually encounter any kind of thing. Even if it's a small snake bite, no matter how small or how like non-poisonous or little bit poisonous it would be there, even if a neurotoxic venom is actually there in your body, it would be very difficult for the trek group to bring you back on the road and get you to the nearest hospital. So just make sure that whenever you are on the wild, make sure that always, if you are walking in a walk path, try to use a trek pole. A trek pole is very helpful, because the trek pole, in every two or three steps you actually put the trek pole on the ground, so both hands, it's subsequent like a trek pole impact on the land, and subsequently it creates a vibration on the land, and vibration is not good for snakes. So whenever there is a vibration, the snake would actually veer off from the particular path, and they would not encounter your leg, or they would not come near your leg. So this is a technique which is followed. If you don't have a walking pole, because that might be expensive for you, you can just take a like a small stick which would be helpful for you to actually walk with. Or if you just walk into your nearby hardware store, then you can buy an Astral half inch pipe which would be like 3 feet, so you can buy it, and you can just put some duct tape on the top. That should give you a good grip, and you can use it as a walking pole. So that is something which you can actually do. You can just buy the hard one, not the soft one, which is the half inch PU pipe that you get for your internal plumbing, right? So this is just a technique which is for people who actually are in the trek or want to do treks and with limited gears. So just if you like this video, please like and subscribe my channel. My name is Sadiq Abdi, under the banner of Abdi Travels. You can find me in Facebook, YouTube, and in Instagram. So please subscribe to my channel. Take care. Bye-bye. Good day, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.